Good morning, everyone. I just want to make sure that you're able to hear me. Please type in the chat if you're able to hear me. Perfect. We're going to wait for 1 minute and then we can start.
Okay. Should I go to share screen now or we just wait?
Hello, Dr. Badri. Thank you for joining. Yes, please go ahead and start sharing your screen. I'll be grateful.
Okay.
Please, everyone, make sure that you mute your microphone.
Should I start now?
Just a second, because we're still receiving people. Okay. I apologize, just a few seconds.
Okay, that's fine, that's okay.
Okay, so give me the chance to actually introduce you and thank you for giving us this lecture. Dr. Badri is a professor of audiovestibular medicine at Minya University in Egypt, and he's also a board member of the Arab Balance Society. Thank you for being with us today, and I'll be grateful if you can share with us the screen so we can make sure that you are able to we're able to see your screen.
Okay. Should I start? It's...
Yes, please. Can we share your screen, okay. Please?
Okay, I'm sharing it. It's okay now? Should I start the presentation?
Just a second, because we're not able to see your screen. Let's make sure we see it. Sorry for the slight delay, but can you share it again? Because we're not able to see it. I apologize.
Okay. That's fine.
Okay, I think we started seeing your screen. Perfect.
Okay.
Okay, you can start. Thank you, sir.
Okay, is okay now? Can I start now?
Yes, perfect. Please go ahead.
Still, I don't hear you well. So, you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you perfectly. We can hear you.
Okay, so I will start, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum, good morning, good afternoon, and hello everybody. I'd like to thank Dr. Sola and Dr. Vargal for inviting me to share with you this valuable session. I hope everyone will get benefit from it. My presentation is about the clinical presentation or the clinical varieties of vestibular migraine. Vestibular migraine, it is the syndrome caused by migraine and present itself with the attack of spontaneous or positional vertigo. Such an association between migraine and vertigo is quite old and dated back probably to 1873. However, probably it is only past decades that vestibular migraine become well established and well documented vestibular pathology. There are several names that describe the same syndrome: vestibular migraine, migraine as vertigo, migraine associated vertigo, migraine associated dizziness, migraine related vestibulopathy. However, the standard name now that's chosen by the International Classification of Headache Disorder and also chosen by the Parani Society is vestibular migraine, which has become almost the standard that describe the vestibular symptom and signs that occur with the migraine. It's a very common disorder. Actually, it is the most common cause of episodic vertigo in adults and children. So it is the most common cause of recurrent episodic vertigo in adults and in children too. It's quite common in the general population. It affects up to 1% of the general population. It is the most common cause of vestibular disorder after benign paroxysmal positional vertigo. In fact, some recent reports suggest that vestibular migraine, it is more common, even more common than benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, and that affect up to 2.7% of the population. So we are dealing with one of the, at least the second most common vestibular disorder and the most common cause of episodic and recurrent vertigo in children and adults. And this is not surprisingly when we know that the migraine itself, it is quite common disorder. It affects at least 20% of the general population, and at least one third of the migraineous population will develop the symptom of vertigo and will have this vestibular migraine at a time after the onset of migraine. Definitely vestibular migraine, it is much more common than well-known and well-established and well-studied pathologies as vestibular neuritis and Meniere. However, still vestibular migraine, although it is so common, it is still overlooked, still misdiagnosed by many physicians, audiologists, and vestibular specialists. It can occur at any age. It can occur in children. But most commonly, it occurs after an average of 8 years after the onset of migraine. So in average, it occurs about 8 years after the onset of migraine itself. However, in some people population, like in women around the nipples, those women had migraine very early in life around adolescence or in 20s, and they stopped to have any migraineous headache at all. And then around the menopause, they develop the vertigo even without the migraineous headache. And this vertigo is a kind of vestibular migraine. As migraine itself, vestibular migraine is common, it's much more common in female, and it is there is evidence for a familiar clustering of the vestibular migraine, like migraine itself, and also there is evidence of some gene inheritance with lower penetrance in male, which may explain why the pathology is less common in male than female. There is no vestibular test or lab test or definite test to diagnose vestibular migraine. It is the diagnosis of vestibular migraine depends exclusively on the on the history. And we have criteria to diagnose vestibular migraine, which is published by the International Classification of Headache Disorder, and it's published also by the Parani Society. And we have four criteria to diagnose the vestibular migraine. The first criteria is that the patient has a current or previous history of migraine according to the International Classification of Headache Disorder. So it is not necessary that the subject has current history of migraine. Just a history of previous history of migraine is quite enough with the other criteria to establish the diagnosis of vestibular migraine. And the subject have at least 4 episodic vestibular system in the form of a sense of rotation of surroundings, self-rotation, imbalance, positional vertigo, whatever, of moderate or severe intensity. So with current or previous history of migraine and at least 5 episodic attack of vestibular symptom, and in 50% of those attack should be one of the migraine symptom, headache, photophobia, phonophobia, visual aura, or whatever, that we'll discuss it in, very soon. And the last criteria and other causes that for vertigo and headache should be excluded. These are the 4 criteria to diagnose vestibular migraine. For the vestibular symptom, the most common symptom is vertigo or rotation or rotational vertigo, sense of rotation of surrounding of self rotation. Close to or more than 2/3 of patients of vestibular migraine have such episodes. Another category of vestibular migraine, they have positional vertigo, either with the spontaneous rotational vertigo, so they have the same spontaneous rotational vertigo that is increased or accentuated by certain position. But in some category of vestibular migraine, patients have only positional vertigo by making exactly the presentation of benign paroxysmal positional vertigo. They don't have episodic or spontaneous vertigo, and will come to such category soon. One of the important character of vestibular migraine, it is the same character of migraine itself. It is highly heterogeneous. It's highly heterogeneous in its presentation. There is marked variability in the duration and frequency of the episodes or attack in between patients. Actually, there is marked variability and heterogeneity in the symptomatology within the same subject. The attack duration may vary from seconds to 2 days, and the attack frequencies will vary from very frequent attack, maybe one or more attack per week, to attack per year. And the same subject may have clustering of attack within certain period and then have no attacks for several months. They have severe attack recurrent and then just attack for few seconds. And this highly heterogeneity and variability, which is very important and very character of the vestibular migraine itself. But especially, in general, usually the attack of spontaneous vertigo take several hours. And in the vast majority of patients with vestibular migraine, the attack is much longer than the attack of Meniere disease. With the vertigo or with the episodes of spontaneous vertigo, they should have at least one of the migraine symptoms. It is to be noted that the most common migraine symptom, or the most famous or the most populous migraine symptoms, which is migraine headache, is absent in 50% of subjects of vestibular migraine during the attack. So 50% of the patient with vestibular migraine during the attack may not have headache. So the absence of headache during the attack does not exclude the diagnosis of vestibular migraine. Even if the headache is there, there is marked temporal relationship between headache and vertigo. Sometimes headache precedes vertigo, sometimes headache occurs after vertigo, and sometimes headache occurs coincident with the vertigo. But the most common migraine symptom in vestibular migraine patient is phonophobia and photophobia, especially photophobia. In one study, we have more than 90% of patients of vestibular migraine reported presence of phonophobia during the attack. It is to be noted that those